Hey everyone, today we are going to talk about spondylolisthesis and best exercises available for this. There are multiple exercises that we are going to demonstrate in the video. If you feel any exercise aggravating or disturbing your pain, please stop that exercise then and there. And there are multiple exercises available beyond the scope of the video, but we have kept safety and precaution as like the primary concern in this video. So all those exercises that you are seeing in the video, they are safe, they are not going to aggravate your problem anytime. However, if you still feel like that, stop that exercise then and there and just discuss the same thing with your physiotherapist so that you can gain the maximum benefit out of the exercise. Now let's watch how this video is. And hold the stretch. You will feel a very good stretch around the lower back. It is a very good posterior pelvic tilt exercise for the patient of spondylolisthesis. The maximum duration of stretch that you can hold is 30 seconds around that area. For beginners, start with 10 second stretch. If you are doing 10 second stretch, do it for 10 repetition. If you are doing 30 second stretch, do it for 3 repetitions only. The next one is prayer stretch. You are sitting down on your heels and then moving both the hand towards the right side. This will give you a good stretch on the left side of your lower back, and you may feel it around the arm as well, because there is one muscle which is attached from your hip to the shoulder. You are just trying to stretch the same muscle. Then you have to change the side and keep both the hands towards the other side and hold it there for about 30 seconds. Don't try to lift your hip in this particular exercise to make it easy. The hip should stay down as much as possible. The next exercise we are going to demonstrate is knee to chest exercise. You have to lie down first on your back and then hold the knee with both the hands and try to move the knee towards the chest. Hold the stretch at least for 10 seconds in case of beginners. Those who are doing some sort of regular exercise, you can hold the stretch for 30 seconds. After holding it for 30 seconds, you have to change the side and do the same thing on the other side. Whenever you are trying to improve the flexibility of any muscle, the duration of stretch should be there for about 30 seconds. But the people who are not accustomed with the exercise, they can do it for less duration. So this is a piriformis stretch. You are keeping a finger of 4, holding the thigh there and maintaining the stretch for 30 seconds. Same thing, 10 seconds for beginner, 30 seconds for 3 repetition in case of 30 second stretch, 10 repetition in case of 10 second stretch. Okay, when you're doing this particular stretch, the leg which is crossed, you will feel the stretch on that particular leg. Maintain your normal breathing throughout the exercise. The next exercise that I'm going to demonstrate is pelvic tilt exercise. You're just trying to squeeze the hip and tilt the pelvis as if you are just trying to roll the tailbone up towards the ceiling. This one is a hamstring stretch. You are using a stretch band. You can use a towel as well. This is a fixed rope kind of thing. You are just holding this position for 30 seconds to improve the flexibility around the back side of the thigh. Sustain the stretch for some time, and afterwards this is another exercise for posterior pelvic tilt with core contraction. So you are keeping your legs about 90 degree, holding a ball between the knee and squeezing the hip, squeezing the abdomen, and just trying to tilt the pelvis. Focus on your hip as well as your abdomen area when you're performing this exercise. When you're going up, hold the position for 10 seconds and then lower it down. Do it again, hold the repetition for 10 seconds and lower it down. As you are seeing in this view, the ball is getting squeezed when you are performing this exercise. This also engages the pelvic floor muscles, which is very important part. Now this is a calf stretch. One leg is up, one leg is down on the stair. You are allowing the heel to go down and you will feel a very good stretch in the calf area. Take some support from the side rail, and whenever you are doing this stretch, just hold the stretch for 30 seconds and never do it without shoes.